Today we'll start the new chapter, that is chapter 7, Our Rights and Duties. So the first topic is the Constitution of India. In the last two chapters, we have read about how our government is formed, how our leaders are elected, and the role of the government at each level. So in the last two chapters of the SST, we have already read about how our Indian government is formed, how the leaders are elected, and how and what are the role of the Indian government in each level. But have you ever wondered where the rules of the leaders and the government are written? So we should, or you can say in your mind, there might come, you can say, a question that how these rules and regulation of the leaders and the governments are, or you can say where they are written, right? So have you ever heard of the term constitution? So it is written in the constitution. Let us find out what do you mean by the term constitution. A constitution is set of documents which lay down the basic principle that a state or a country is governed by. So what do you mean by the term constitution? A constitution is a set of document, that means it is a set of a book where the basic principle, that is the rules and regulation of a country or of a state, is written, that how that particular country or the state will be governed, that is how that particular state or the country will be organized. In a democracy, a constitution describes the system of voting and how rules or laws have to be made. So in a democracy, that means in a democratic form of government, that is every individual have the rights to participate in an election when they are of the age of 18 and above. So this is called a democracy. Okay, so in a democracy, that is in India, a constitution, that means a document, is described as the system of voting, that means, and how rules and laws have been made. So in a constitution, the system of election, that means how the election will take place, okay, what are the different types of procedures and how different types of rules and regulation will be made and how they will be implemented, who will implement it in the country. So every rules and regulation are written in the constitution. It describes the role of the leader and the government. So in the constitution, not only the rules and regulation, but also different types of functions of the leaders and the Indian government are also written. A constitution also contains the role of a citizens of a country. So in the constitution, what are the different types of role that a particular citizen have to do in order to, or you can say, who are living in a country. So in short, we can say that constitution is document in which all the different types of rules and regulation are written how to run a country. The Constitution of India was formed by the Constituent Assembly on 26 November 1949. So when did the Indian Constitution was formed? It was formed in the year 1949 on 26 November by the Constituent Assembly. The constitution came into effect on 26 January 1950. So though it was formed in the year 1949, but it came into effect on 26 January 1950. Since then, the Republic Day is celebrated every year to mark the adoption of the Indian Constitution. So why we celebrate 26 January every year as a Republic Day? Because our Indian Constitution was adopted, or you can say it was came into force from this day. That's why it is, this day is celebrated as the Republic Day in our country. The Constitution is the supreme law of our land. So the Constitution, that means the rules and regulation, is the supreme law. Whatever is written in the Constitution, a country have to follow that. All the laws which are made by the government must conform to the constitution. So whatever the laws which are made by the Indian government, they have to refer the constitution so that they can confirm. That means whatever the rules and regulation which are made by the Indian government, it is up to, or you can say it is appropriate for, according to our Indian constitution or not. Okay. The Indian Constitution is the longest written constitution in the world. So the Indian Constitution is one of the longest constitution in the world.